In May 1960, the Soviets shot down a U-2 spy plane over Soviet airspace. U-2s could fly at 70,000 feet, but apparently that was not high enough. We needed to go higher, to space. So the US needed a satellite that could take pictures. The thing is, a U-2 flight, it eventually lands. The film and the cameras can be taken out and developed. If we launch a satellite, we needed a way to get the film from space to intelligence officers on the ground, and that had never been done before. They worked for years, but eventually the CIA launched the United States' first spy satellite, Corona. Corona's first onboard camera was 5 feet long and could see things about 40 feet across, like a building. It was America's first imaging satellite and also the first US satellite program ever. Since it used film, Corona would take pictures and then drop the film in heavy buckets back to Earth. The buckets would re-enter the atmosphere and then be caught by a claw hook hanging off of a military cargo plane or be recovered by ships after splashdown, assuming the bucket didn't sink, which did happen. This was the first time humans had recovered anything that had been sent to space, and though it was crazy, it became hugely successful. Pictures were taken of Soviet or Chinese missile sites, which helped the US monitor and negotiate Cold War treaties. The first Corona model, Keyhole 1, only lasted about a day, but it gave way to lots more models. Kodak made the film lighter. Engineers designed better cameras and capsules. Eventually, the engineers achieved a 2-foot resolution. You could see people standing around military bases all over the world. Over the 12 years of the project, the US launched over 120 Keyhole satellites and took over 800,000 images. We know all this because it was declassified in the 1990s. President Clinton and Vice President Gore released the images to the public to help environmental efforts, because these were the oldest satellite maps of our planet. Today, you can just go online and spy on a zoo in North Korea. You can look at Strategic Missile Site F on the border of Nebraska and Wyoming, which makes you wonder, what can the satellites that are still classified see? For more epic stories of innovation that shaped our future, check out theageofaerospace.com. If you enjoyed this video, please take a second and subscribe to our channel. Imaging our planet changed how we do a lot of things, but on my new Facebook show, How Close Are We?, we're talking about taking pictures of the black hole at the center of our galaxy. How close are we to seeing it? Find out on Facebook. The link is in the description. Thanks for watching, everyone.